Introducing a SwiftUI splash screen is a fantastic way to captivate your users from the moment they launch your iOS app. In just a few steps, you can craft a visually engaging and informative screen that sets the tone for their experience. In this tutorial, I'll walk you through the process of creating a SwiftUI splash screen, allowing you to make a lasting first impression and provide a seamless transition into your app's main content. Let's dive in. And if you'd like to learn more about SwiftUI, check out DevFactory at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Now, let me just show you what we are going to build out today. So here is my demo project. I'm just going to build it around. Take notice, here is our splash screen. Really, really nice. Now, this is what we are going to build out, and we are going to do this from scratch. I'm going to move on to my other Xcode project. What I added is an Apple logo image and a background image, you know, just to see the actual main content of our application. And we have our content view. It's the same thing. Let me just remove the canvas. And what we are going to do is, let's just split this splash screen feature into its components. We are going to have a container view, then the content view, and also a splash screen view. So let's start by modifying this content view. I'm going to add the background image. So let's remove all of this and let's have an image right over here. BG is the name of my asset, and let's make this resizable and scale to fill. There we go. So if I build and run right now, you will see that we actually have this, you know, this image of the App Store. Okay, so that's our content view. And we are going to leave it at this. You know, you have your own content view. Let's build out the splash screen. Ready to dive into the exciting world of SwiftUI? Join me for an engaging mentoring session at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Whether you're just starting or want to level up your SwiftUI game, I'm here to guide you every step of the way. Let's explore SwiftUI's magic together and create stunning iOS apps that will leave your users in awe. Don't wait, let's embark on this SwiftUI adventure. Visit rebeloper.com/mentoring now and let's get started. The link is down in the description. So let's create a new file right over here. SwiftUI view, next. There we go, splash screen view. And we are going to add this splash screen view and the content view into a container view. So let's create a new file right over here. Again, a SwiftUI view. Let's have this as a container view. There we go, let's create that. And right over here, we want to store the state of the splash screen, of course. Therefore, we are going to create a state variable, state private var. So is splash screen view presented? And by default, this will be, of course, set to true. That's the starting position. We are going to have a splash screen presented. So therefore, right over here, I'm going to say if it's not presented, so is splash screen view not presented, we are going to go with the content view. Otherwise, we are going to go for our splash screen view. And that's our container view. We want to put it inside the app file instead of the content view. So container view. Okay, so if we just build and run now, we should see a hello world from the splash screen view. There we go, hello world, really nice. So let's build out our splash screen view. Let me just show this animation again. So there we go, it's just moving up, having some flickers, and then just changing into the Apple logo that we can see right now. That's the new branding, and it's just scaling up. Let me just build and run one more time so you get a better glance of it. It's just scaling up, flickering, and just expanding and moving to our content view. Okay, so just moving back to our splash screen project here. What do we want to do? Well, we are going to have a background of black. So if you were paying attention, we had a background. Therefore, I'm going to use a Z stack right over here. Let's have a color dot black, and we are just going to say it ignores safe area edges. Okay, so that's our Z stack. What else do we want? Well, we want the logo, but we have two logos. We have the Apple logo from system named images, and we are also going to have the logo that we added into our asset catalog, and that together will scale up and do all of its things. So we are going to create another Z stack for that outside of the background color, of course. So the Z stack, we are going to have an image, the image of system name, and it's Apple logo what we want, and the font size is dot system, and I have some magic numbers right over here that I have tested on my demo project. Yeah, I'm just going to add them. Of course, you are going to use different numbers for your logo. So system name sized 1.5. okay, foreground style, that's basically foreground style, setting the color dot white. Foreground color has been deprecated in iOS 17. Okay, so foreground style white, and then we want to set an opacity, because first, this is not what we see. We see the other older logo. So we want to change that opacity. Therefore, we are going to create a state variable for that, state private var, and that would be system image opacity. System image opacity. There we go. And that will be a double. So let's set this to 0.0. Let's have the opacity set on this image, and that is system image opacity. Okay. Now we can't see it because the opacity is set to zero. What can we see is the other image. So let's have that image with the resource name, and that is Apple logo. Okay, let's make this, of course, resizable and scaled to fit. And now we also want to set an opacity for this because, you know, it's just going to disappear. Therefore, I'm going to duplicate this line, command D, and I'm just going to name this image opacity. So let's set that to our image opacity, that is image opacity. Okay, also because this is an actual image, we want to set a frame of a width and height. 100 is the magic number again here. Feel free to just change this to your specific image. And then I found out that this Apple logo is a little bit off. So I'm just going to have an offset of X of 1. It's just tedious, but just a small tweak right over there. Okay, so let's see how this looks like. Because, yeah, we should have... Oh, sorry, the image opacity should be set to 1 because we should see that Apple logo. Okay, let's just wait for that. There we go. We have our Apple logo. Really, really nice. Okay, but we want to also scale it up. And what do we want to scale? Well, these two images, actually the Z stack. So we are going to have also a scale. So let's have another state variable, maybe on top, state private var. And this will be scale. And it's a CG size. The scale needs a CG size with the width and height. Now, you could just have... CG size 0, but that will scale from nothing and it doesn't look really well. So I'm just having 0.8 and 0.8 for the width and height. Okay, so let's set the scale effect of scale, that CG size right over there. Okay, so let's see it now. Yeah, it will be just a little bit smaller than previously. As you can see, this is our starter point. Now, what do we want to add next? Well, this Z stack will actually need to be removed after our animation has been added. Therefore, I'm going to also add an opacity. So let's just duplicate this and let's just have simply an opacity. Opacity and one is okay. So let's have that on the Z stack. So opacity, and that is just opacity. Okay. Finally, we want to do the whole animation. Now, everything is set in place. Well, actually, not really. We still need to know how to remove this flash screen view, and that can be done inside the container view. You know, is flash screen view presented? Therefore, we need a binding. So, binding var is presented. And that will be of type boolean. And let's just add this also to our preview real quickly. Let's have a constant right over here, dot true. Okay. So now on the container view, we are missing is presented right over here. And let's bind this to is splash screen view presented. Now it's time to do the actual animation. So let's go back to our splash screen view, which I spelled out incorrectly. So let's just refactor that real quickly. Okay, everywhere and splash screen view. Great. So when this view appears, dot on appear, we want to perform some action. And yeah, we are going to do a lot of animations right over here. So for starter, let's just scale it up. Let's just scale it up and yeah, that would be done with an animation. So with animation, we want to scale it up. So we want to have a scale set to CG size and the width and height 1 and 1. Okay, let's see how this looks like because yeah, it should look just really fine. Yeah, I know if you have blinked, you missed it, but it's just scaling it all the way up. Now, I don't really like the, you know, it's really snappy, it's linear. So we have on the width animation some options that we can add over here. And I like the ease in and out with the duration. And also, I really like that you can set the duration with the ease in, ease out, or ease in, out with the duration. And I found 1.5 seconds to be really great. So let's build and run and see how it looks right now. As you can see, it's much slower. Really nice. This is what I was looking for. Also, after this, but during this scale, I want to set the system image's opacity. You know, this is set to 0 by default. I want to set this system image opacity to 1. So yeah, it's just going to set its opacity in. I know we can't see it, maybe a little bit of glimpse right over here at the bottom and at the leaf, but basically it's just scanning it up. It's behind the Apple logo image, the old Apple logo image. Okay, that's fine. Now we have two of the images with an opacity of 1. Now we want to wait for this duration to take occur. So we want to have a dispatch queue. So dispatch queue, there we go, dispatch queue dot main dot async after a deadline from now. And we are going to execute some stuff. Let me remove this part so we can see the code a lot better. So what do we want to do? Well, we actually want to scale it all the way up. So forget about the flicker just for now. We are going to scale it all the way up. So from now, what do we want to add in here? Well, I'm going to add plus 2.5 seconds, oh, not equals, but plus 2.5 seconds. So we can see that, in, you know, the logo scaled up for a while. And also we need the flicker during that 1 second. So we just wait 2.5 seconds and then we are going to execute another with animation. And we are going to go a dot is... let's see, easing in just for now. And we are going to have 0.35, so 35, 0.35. What do we want to do? Well, we want to scale all the way up and we want to set the opacity to 0 for everything. So let's just scale this up to, let's say, CG size of width 50 and height 50. Okay. Again, this is just scale effect, not the actual size of the view that we added the scale onto. And also we want to set the opacity to zero. Again, this is with animation. So let's see that. There we go. Let's just see how this looks like. So we're just scaling up, waiting for 1 second and just scaling it all the way up and just removing everything from the view, which is really, really nice. Okay. So, now we are going to add, you know, we want to move from our splash screen view to our content view. So after all of this, again, I'm going to copy this out because, you know, just typing dispatch queue all the time, it takes a lot of time. So after this 0.35 seconds has elapsed, I just want to wait a little bit more. Therefore, I'm just going to go for 0.4 seconds after. I'm going to say is in with a duration of 0.2. We are going to say is presented dot toggle. Now, we are going to ease in with the duration with animation. Is presented is going to change, and the default is just opacity, which is what we want. So let's build and run and see how it looks like. So just scaling up, waiting, and then just moving away to the other view. Really, really nice. Okay, so finally, let's add that little flicker animation that we saw. So it's just going to switch from the old Apple logo to the new Apple logo. So before we even, so after we scale up, we are going to add some sort of, not before, here is our scale. So before we scale all the way up, we are going to do a succession of opacity changes. And we are going to do that inside the for view, so a for loop. So for I in 0 till 6, so 7 minus 1. And we are going to use this to have, again, another dispatch queue. So let me just paste that in and remove all of its contents. Now, what about, what is now? Well, first of all, we want to wait 1.5 seconds that we got from this duration. And then we also want to wait I multiplied by 0.1 second, let's just say. We are going to need to have this turned into a double. There we go, we have that. Okay, so what do we want to do? Well, we want to toggle the actual image opacity right over here. And that's really simple. If image opacity equals 0.0, then we are going to set the image opacity, image opacity set to 1. Otherwise, we are going to set it back to 0. Image opacity set to 0. Okay, so basically that's it. We are having 6 of these, so 7 of these, because we want to switch from the old logo to the new logo. There we go. Let's just see that one more time. Really nice. Now that is a really cool splash screen view animation. And if you want to check out what is night mode and how you can add it to your own applications, go ahead and check out the video. It's right over here.